People who have had friends stab you in the back, what is the story? Asked two of my friends if they wanted to live together in college. Then one of them asked another person in our friend group if he wanted to join in as well. Then they asked another, and another. And then once there were too many people for one apartment, they dropped me out of it. No longer friends with any of them. Was kinda a wake-up call though, because I definitely gave way too much of myself to those people, not knowing that I was the most expendable one. It really taught me not to put others on a pedestal and respect myself more, and has since led to me developing far more healthy relationships that bring me a lot of happiness. I've told bits and pieces of this story before, but in short, several years ago I moved to Florida, almost immediately after I met a friend. He was a great guy, so I thought, and we'd constantly hang out. He'd show me around the town, this state, etc. About a year and a half of knowing him, he stole a couple of my credit cards and racked up really big bills. Unfortunately for me, and I know this now but did it then, I simply thought calling the credit card company to report your card stolen and cancelling the account also vacated the charges. That's not true. You actually have to formally contest the charges separately, and you only have 60 days. By the time I realized this, it was too late. I tried, in vain, to semi-reconcile with him to try to get a payment plan. He begged me not to call the police. I regret now that I didn't. I do believe that he had fallen on hard times, and he would get back on his feet and try to repay me. That didn't happen, although later on he did get arrested for something else and was put on probation. I figured that would have been the best time to try to recoup the money lost. I had fallen behind on these payments and my credit was starting to suffer. I had to drop out of college because of that. I did try instead to take him to small claims court. I do realize that civil court is not criminal, but with him now being a convicted felon, I might stand a better chance at looking much better. Instead, when we got to court, he denied everything, said everything was a gift, and completely slandered me in open court. Why he was allowed to get away with it is beyond me, but the case was dismissed. I got nothing. My credit suffered for years because of that. I eventually did save up enough money to file for bankruptcy to just get rid of that debt that I couldn't repay. Nor should I have had to. I have never really forgiven him for what he did to me. A fake, he still lives around. Luckily, I haven't seen him in several years. IDK what I'd even say if I ever did encounter him. The bankruptcy did eliminate that debt, so I cannot, and will not, ever say he owes me anything monetarily. But he owes me a huge apology. But like I said, I would seriously doubt the sincerity of it and likely wouldn't accept it anyway. I think the best is as it is now. He just stays away from me. This all starts out poorly by me following my boyfriend to the same college he went to. He was a year older. Still don't regret it after all, as I loved my school and everything else at those 4 years. We were a bit off again. On again first semester I was there again. Red flags. My new across the hall mate in my dorm became my best friend. She and boyfriend didn't really like each other, but it wasn't a huge deal, just a personality clash, and she didn't like how he treated me with the on-off crap. Our school had a winter term in January. Boyfriend lived off campus, so he was there and best friend was taking a class. I was home. Best friend was lonely and didn't know many other people on campus for winter term, so I told her to hang out with the boys in my boyfriend's frat house, whom she had friendly-ish with. So they all start hanging out, and by that, of course, I mean they start hooking up. I get back to school and I immediately can tell things are weird with best friend. Unbeknownst to me at the time, boyfriend has had basically our entire relationship to practice covering his tracks and is a smooth and practiced liar by this point. Within a couple weeks, it all comes out that they'd been hooking up, and best friend actually tells me, "You know how much I've wanted a boyfriend. If you were a good friend, you'd let me have him." Why I still wanted to date him at this point is beyond many people's comprehension, including mine, but it did involve a dog that I was beyond attached to. I do fault them both equally, and did at the time too. I don't remember being mad at either of them as much as I was just devastated. He was apologetic from the start. She was mean and manipulative again, not trying to say it was the other woman's fault, just explaining how it all went down. It totally sucked, and I felt so betrayed by both of them. Unsurprisingly, I have had a lot of trust and loyalty issues since. In 2014, I woke up the 1st of January in horrible pain. I ended up needing an emergency surgery to remove my gallbladder. I was a single mom to two kids under 5 and had just moved back to my hometown after living out of state. We'd had to leave a really shitting living situation and had only been back about a month, and I had not found a job at that point. I had had a really close family friend who had been living with me before I had moved back, and he ended up homeless, so I bought him an $80 bus ticket and got him back to our hometown and let him stay with me a few days. He quickly found another place to stay, but we had invited him to my youngest son's second birthday, which is the 6th of Jan. I was like 4 days out from surgery at this point and could barely make it down my stairs at this point, so he offered to go and pick up a pizza and cake for my son for me. We didn't have a huge party or anything. I was on food stamps and had cash assistance since my son's dad was not involved at all and did not pay child support. Even so, I offered for him to get himself a small pizza to take back to the girl he was staying with, since her and her kids couldn't make it over. So party goes great, everyone has a good time, especially both my kids. A few days later, my grandma was going to go grocery shopping for me, so I go to get my card and realize it's not there. I never got it back from the guy, and I forgot he even had it since I was all doped up on pain meds from surgery. I tried calling him like 5 times and he didn't answer, so I get onto my account online to check my balance and he took everything. I had like $600 in cash, paid my rent and bought my kids the things they needed, and then I had like $750 in food stamps. All of it was gone. He let the girl he was staying with convince him to steal my money from me. I'd only use the money to buy the bus ticket and the pizza and cake for my son, since I'd been in the hospital for the first 4 days of the year and only home for 2 after that. It is still to this day the most intentionally fucked up thing anyone has ever done to me, mostly because it was such a huge fuck you to my kids. Like, who steals from a single mom recovering from a life-saving surgery on her kid's birthday, especially after I helped him? Like, holy shit. I've got 2 stories about the same person, but I'll tell the one that did it involve me and relates more to your story. My friend from high school moved away to college and got his first roommate. They became good friends, lived together all through college and after the dorms. After college, my friend moved back to our hometown and lived with his mom. About a year later, the college roommate moved to our hometown and they both lived together again for a few years, probably 6 or 7 years of being friends and living together. They drank together, hung out, all the normal friend stuff. I moved out of the hometown across the country, partially due to the falling out with this friend. Different story though, I stayed in touch with the roommate and most other friends in the hometown. Then it's a Friday night and the roommate's birthday. They are still living together, so logically they'd be going out and getting drinks. Well, the friend invites a bunch of people over to their place to pregame before going out to the bars. I get a Snapchat from the roommate and he's playing video games on the computer. So I wish him a happy birthday and check in on him to see how he's doing and what his birthday plans are. He says he doesn't have any plans. Meanwhile, via Snapchat stories, I see the friend having the friends over in the living room drinking and doing pregame drinking games. You can see the roommate's door in some of the snaps. Next stories from the friend are of them all downtown drinking and dancing, without the roommate on his birthday. I asked the roommate what was going on with that. The friend didn't tell the roommate that people were coming over. Didn't invite him to go to drink in the common areas with them, didn't invite him to go down to the bars, and didn't even wish him a happy birthday at all. They had been friends for like 7 years at this point, so the friend definitely knew when his birthday was, since they had celebrated many times in the past. They are not friends anymore. But a good bud of mine, who's the godfather of my son, living with me and my wife. I travel a lot for work, and was out of the country for about 6 months in the Middle East. Came back and found out she was pregnant, with twins, and that they weren't mine. Years ago, when I did a health sciences undergraduate degree, most of the cohort was determined to get into medical school. Our medical school program mainly accepted students from only our competitive undergraduate course, due to subject prerequisites. We all knew each other and were friendly, hanging out together and forming study groups. Many of my friends were great. We shared tips, resources, practiced exams and interviews together. But there were a handful who really wanted to get into medical school, and since the program ranks applicants mainly based on undergraduate results, the better your friends perform, the lower your ranking is for selection. So near application time, some of us would head off to the university library to borrow our textbooks to find chapters or page numbers that the lecturer mentioned would be on the exam, and they would be ripped out. You'd go and find another library copy of the textbook, and the page would be ripped out too. All of them, totally removed in a hurry. I didn't believe that someone from our cohort did it, until interview practice began. Students began obtaining copies of the questions from previous years and lying when others asked if they had it. I saw someone give a terrible, awful interview answer and the other student would give them glowing feedback and inform them they should say that, word for word, during the interview. It was a shit hour and a lot of relationships fell apart, or were never the same again. My wife said she needed some time for herself, so she went to stay at her mom's for a while. One day I went to pick up my kids and walked in on her and my best friend having sex. Turns out it had been going on for a while and she knew him before she knew me, which I had no clue about. Edit. This kinda blew up and I can't really reply to every comment question, so I just wanted to add a few things. When I said the affair had been going on for a while, I mean for several months before I found out. This was after my second son was born. I have no doubts as to whether my kids are actually mine or not. Yes, they are now my ex-wife and ex-best friend. This happened nearly 16 years ago now. It was a very dark period in my life, but I'm great now. I got two great kids out of the relationship. I wouldn't have met my wife if this hadn't happened. Also, I believe I'm a stronger person having gone through the whole ordeal. Just know that if you're going through something horrible in life and your heart and mind are broken, there is hope for things to get better. It just takes time. I had a best friend that I knew for 16 years. She got pregnant and her parents tried to kick her out. Her parents wanted her to get an abortion but she refused. One of our HS friends told me someone should push her down a flight of stairs so she can miscarry. I told her that's a very bad idea and defended my best friend. The next day, the principal came by my class to ask me if I could attend a meeting about something important. If I didn't attend, I was going to be expelled. When I arrived at the meeting, our shared friend claimed I was going to shove my best friend down flights of stairs so she can miscarry. My best friend believed her. We stopped talking after that. My husband and I had a friend that we helped get back on his feet, paid off some tickets he had, got his license reinstated, hooked him up with a solid connection for a reasonable, well-running car to replace his beater, and gave him a place to live and a job. Automotive repair, he decided it was a better choice to tell all our customers we were overcharging them. Spoiler, we weren't, and he'd do the jobs cheaper if they'd bring it to him at his house. This was a short time after he moved out of our house, after never repaying anything he owed us, not that we'd asked, broke my heart. A woman I thought was my friend, we worked together for years, our kids were friends, I helped her and her husband out when he was having mental health problems, she was in my sister's wedding party, appeared in court as a witness for my ex-wife in a bid to gain full custody. Thankfully she failed and I now have custody of my kids. I haven't spoken to my friend since. My mother told me she was sick of being with Dad. She told me a bunch of things he'd done which made her afraid of him. She asked me to tell a few of her close friends about how she was being treated, because she wanted them to understand why she was leaving. Then she decided to stay with him. So she told her friends that she had no idea what was wrong with me, but they should pray for me because it looked like I was going through something. My own mother stabbed me in the back. I had one friend. I was bullied by everyone at elementary school. Because my friend would be bullied too when they hung out with me at school, we only played outside of school. One day a popular kid asked to play with me during recess. I was ecstatic, until after a while they said you're not as bad as friends said you are, and that's how I learned why I was bullied. Made plans to go see a movie with my friends for my 16th birthday and planned it weeks in advance. Everybody bailed the day before but I decided to still go see the movie. Ran into my whole group of friends leaving the movie theater while buying popcorn. Best friend stopped talking to me after my dad died, took the whole friend group with him. Apparently I was too emotional. I was 13, having my entire friend group walk away from me when I was in such a shitty place stuck with me forever. Thanks for watching. Please give a like if you enjoyed the video and hit subscribe if you want to see more. See you later.